G'day guys, Rob Herbert here from R&N Blades Australia. I'm going to do a quick video on how to maintain your custom knife out in the field, how to put that razor sharp edge on it that it comes to you with when you order it. A lot of people get a little bit concerned and a little bit scared, I guess, because they don't know about how to sharpen their knife, and they do all sorts of wonderful wild things and the knife comes back to me, or any knife comes back to me in a pretty crazy condition. Now, there's some simple things to do to keep your knife sharp out in the field, and that's one thing. As soon as you start to feel it lose that bite, that's when you stop. It's like when you use a chainsaw. If it starts to go from chipping to powder, it's already way too blunt. Now, just for demonstration purposes, and you might want to do this at home, permanent marker, knife blade. And you'll see, no matter which sort of knife you've got, that they all come with a edge that's quite clearly the cutting edge. And you can colour that in, just nice and simply. And this will just take me half a second. Well, so it's now got black texture. You can see that side's not coloured in, and that side's got the black ink on it. Okay, the tools I'm going to use today are American made Easy Lap diamond hones. They're a very easily found product on eBay, on the internet, anywhere, and you can go and buy a non-name product, I guess, but Easy Lap's been around for a long time, and you know that the product that you're going to be getting from them is 100%. So, we get back to what we're doing with the knife. So you're out in the field, you got your animal on the ground, the knife stopped cutting and you need to sharpen it. Some people get a steel out and they start rubbing them on the steel. If you know how to use a steel, it's not a problem. Otherwise, what some people do is they end up with an angle on one side. I guess if I can use the Easy Laps, an angle will be like that on one side and the other side will be like that. They're not making a nice even cutting edge. And then, you know, the knife's pretty much buggered and you've got to go back to starting it again. So with these paddles, it's quite simple. You've coloured your edge in, paddle onto the edge of the knife, start giving it a bit of a rub up, and you'll see when the colour of the texture is disappearing, how far and where you've got to actually improve what you're doing, as in you've got to tilt the sharpener back, put that more that way or more that way. Okay, so I'll just rub out all of that texture mark. It's no big secret, it's not a difficult thing to do. You can go to the $2 shop or to your equivalent. Go and buy yourself a cheap and nasty if you don't want to do this on your favourite hunting knife yet, and give her a bit of a go. Okay, so this side's almost done, and this is a medium paddle that I'm using. You can buy them in sets of three. As you can see on that, I'll just turn this around a bit for you, that all that black texture is gone. Now, to do the other side, it's not that difficult. You don't have to start, you know, working some weirdo angle, you know, around in your hand this way and using your non-master hand and all that sort of thing. Just flip her over, do exactly the same thing. You can colour that in again, then with your paddle. You just keep rubbing, nice and light. You don't need to be too hard and aggressive. And the good thing about being able to watch your angle is you can sort of control how, like some people like to have a fairly long shoulder, as it's called. Some people like to have a short shoulder on the cutting edge. And by that I mean, I the long shoulder is that line from the cutting edge back up here, or short shoulder, that line's closer to the cutting edge. If I've sort of made that easy to understand. For a hunting knife, you know, a lot of people have been sharpening knives for a long time, talk about all of these different angles and can please have it sharpened at 19 degrees or 17 degrees, 15 degrees. You know, there's a lot of people get hung up on that stuff. You don't have to particularly, you know, it's always good and handy, I guess, to know exactly where it's at. But don't get too stressed about it. The other thing too to check is the this pointy end of the knife. If you have a look to see, there should be two triangles that meet, or two lines that are on the same angle, and they should make a perfect little triangle there. So I just need to clean that up a little bit on this one. You can see that it's already making a big difference there. Because what you want, the way to get a really sharp knife is to make sure that those two planes meet perfectly. There we go, we're done. Now so that's with the medium file. Then we roll over to the super fine. Exactly the same. You should be able to hear a bit of a difference. You can hear how fine that is. And you'll see that the fine one, you won't need to mark it with a texture again, because the fine, or the extra fine, will really shine that edge up and take away all of those coarser marks that you've put on there with your Easy Lap. That's almost done there. So if you think about it, you've got your animal down, you're doing your best to harvest it, you're feeding your family, you know, and your knife's stopped cutting. There's nothing worse than struggling for the next hour or 2 hours with a bloody blunt knife. It doesn't matter what steel your knife's made out of, all knives have to be kept in a tip-top condition. So I make knives out of high carbon steels, all the way through to your really super hard stainless steels, and you will never get a knife that will last forever without sharpening. It is an important skill, and it's not a hard skill to learn. Just give that edge a bit of a feel. You should feel it just nice and prickly on your if you're testing it with your thumb. If you just want to feel it, you should be able to feel that that's, you know, you've got a really nice little prickle. It's almost like it picks up all the little grooves in your finger. The other way that you can test that is that you should be able to put the knife on the back of your thumbnail and it shouldn't slip off anywhere. You see a lot of guys shaving hair. I've hardly got any hair left. You know, I haven't even finished this knife and it's shaving. Okay. Right, then the last thing that I do, it's just a piece of hardboard, a carter, and a piece of 4mm Australian leather on the back there, and I just use that as a strop. So that's pretty easy. That's just nice and lightly. It doesn't have to be exactly the same angle, but it'll self-guide it to where it's going, and it just micro-polishes the edge there. And it takes off that little microscopic burr that's on the back of the blade. And that knife's ready to go. That's, I don't know, you can hear that or see that. Alright, so that's ready to keep dressing out your animal. And that's taken me in between explaining, and it was a super blunt knife. you know, to where it is now, I don't know, all of a couple of minutes. Anyway, guys, I'll put some more stuff up on the channel shortly. I hope that you've got something out of that, and that explains some of the myths or the legends of being able to keep a knife sharp. That's all I take field. I keep it in my pack. When I've got a big animal on the ground, that's what I do. All right, guys, till later. See you then.
You're not supposed to say the word cancer.